This old DC motor had collected years of dust, rust, and heavy wear. The rust on the motor had deeply penetrated all the metal and plastic surfaces, making it impossible for the motor to run. Let's bring it back to life. First, I bent open the side tabs and carefully separated the motor into three main pieces: the stator, the rotor, and the back cover with the brushes. Because of the rust that had spread all over the motor, removing the rotor was very difficult. However, I managed to take it out without causing any damage to the motor. All the parts went straight into a container, and I poured in some alcohol to loosen up the grime and dissolve any old grease. This process is ideal for removing the heavy dirt that has built up on the motor parts. At the same time, alcohol does not damage the copper windings or other components, so I can use it safely. After soaking for a while, it was time for a deep clean. I used a wire brush to scrape away the rust. While doing this, I'm extremely careful to avoid any damage to the copper windings. After finishing the cleaning, the rotor now looks like this. To remove any dust that settled into the gaps while clearing the rust, I drop the rotor into a container of alcohol once again. This cover, which holds the brushes, is made of plastic. It has a lot of rust and dirt on it, and many parts of the plastic are deformed. To remove the rust stains, I go over all the areas again with a wire brush. Now I use a soft brush to clean the rust from the plastic parts and the hard-to-reach areas. On the deformed parts of the plastic, I use sandpaper to make the surface smoother. By sanding these areas by hand, I reach as many spots as possible and get a nice clean surface. To clean the dust from the hard-to-reach areas of this cover, I leave it in a container filled with alcohol for a while. To help the motor look like new again, I paint the cover piece black. The stator was completely rusted. First, I roughly cleaned it with a soft brush. The brush wasn't enough, so I continued cleaning all the surfaces with sandpaper. For the area sandpaper couldn't reach, I used a wire brush. Then, I polished the surface using a felt and some wax. With all the cleaning done, I greased the bearing to make it move smoothly. I carefully installed the rotor back into the stator. Next, I put the cover on and closed the side pins. To power the motor, I soldered two wires. The motor was completely unusable before. But now it looks almost like new. I connected power, and it runs perfectly again. Don't forget to like and subscribe for more content.